It's been a whole mess of them flying by. Look at this. It's awful. It's awful. Look at that sky. Horrible.
Going right past the sun. Right into the sun. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, this is real nice. Here we go again. Another plane. Nothing coming out of him. Oh, there's another plane over there. What are you to do? What are you supposed to do? So as my mother waits for me down there while I do this, she's reading the paper, believing everything she reads in the paper. Believing everything she reads in the paper, but not believing what she sees in the sky. She sits there while I walk up this hill and thinks, what is my daughter doing? Has she lost her mind? Or does she know something that I don't really have an idea about, or that I have a grasp on, or can get a grasp on it? She doesn't know what to think. Does she care? She's older. She's not going to have to live through this. Like my daughter will, or your children will have to live through this. The results of it. It's just a shame. Beautiful countryside. Here we go. So as I descend back down to earth, keeping my feet grounded, I listen to the chimes, the bells coming from the churches over here that remind me that there are human beings here living on this earth, breathing the air, eating the food from the fields, the crops around this area, drinking the water. All these people who are orchestrating this mess up there above us don't care. Putting all kinds of crap in the air, aren't they? For what reason? Is it for Agenda 21? I advise everyone to really look up Agenda 21. Because that's what they're looking forward to. And think about the past, the recent past, with the storms, the flooding, the talk of reconstructing the roads, communities, and all that. Has to happen anyways. But they're going to be repossessing a lot of land, claiming it's uninhabitable due to pollution, contamination. They have this under, you know, that so-called weather modification. Yeah, right. They can control the weather. They're going to own the weather. Why do they want to own the weather? You think so that they can make the crops grow better in certain places and that everybody's got a source of supply of water, a good clean source of water? No. So they can flood you, create fiercer storms, destroy, get maximum destruction so that you have to move out. They don't want you to own homes. How many people have been able to modify their loans under the administration's home modification program? I'd like to know how many people really did do that. I'm sure there's a short number. How many people are happy with the way things are going? Not too many. I drive by small town downtowns and look at the storefronts. There's so many vacancies. It's like we are in a depression, basically. Also, homes, foreclosure, auctions, for sale. For sale signs that have been for houses that have been on the market for I don't know how long. There goes another guy up there. You know, I mean, people, you have to wake up and reclaim your government, your country, your land, your world. I'm not saying protest. People are already doing that. But question everybody who's representing you. Your congressman, your senator, your representative, they can't help you. They're even too small. They're ineffective. They're in this as much as we are. Their children, their families. They may think that they're going to have a little bit more privilege. Yeah, they might. Than the ordinary folk. But I'll tell you right now, we don't have a pretty world to look forward to, because you know what? You're just like that little bug right there now. You are almost insignificant, if you are already. Let's see. Anybody see any four-leaf clovers? I should keep my eye on the ground. Look for one, maybe. Here's a little crop. Sure would be nice to find one. But you know what? I don't have the time to look on the ground right now for a small four-leaf clover. Because we have a bigger problem, and it's called chemtrails. Because if you can't breathe, and if you're drinking water that is so contaminated with toxins, you won't even have a three-leaf clover, two-leaf clover, or a beautiful tree for shade once they're done. Yep, that's my day. That's my concern, my obsession. Gee, I don't think it's such a bad obsession to be worried about your future, huh? Your environment. It's kind of important, don't you think? Your commercials, your movies, your textbooks, your science is changing. They're filling your children's minds with new images and new ways to believe that this is your normal sky. Aren't these lines lovely? Don't you like to see them play tic-tac-toe in the sky? Well, they're brainwashing your kids into believing that this is the new norm. What did your skies look like? Maybe probably the same. They've been doing this since the 30s, whenever they could get up there. They've been poisoning people on large scales. So why would this be unbelievable? Why would it be so unbelievable to think that your government could possibly be responsible for something like that? Is it so hard to believe? It isn't for me, because I know my history. Well, from what I've been told. My father was a brilliant man. He knew a lot. But I don't even think he would know this. He has since passed. But I think if he realized what was going on, he'd say, go for it. You get out there, kid, and you tell him, this is wrong. That's what I'm doing, Dad. I'm doing what is right.